Hello students, a very good morning. Jai Hind everyone. Children, so today we are going to start the revision work of UT2, right? I'm sure that you all are must have started preparations, right? And I want to see that everybody is just doing superb, especially in English. In fact, in all the subjects, but in English, if anybody deducts a single number also, na, then see children, right? Because the question paper is not at all very tough, okay? If you have really learned everything, if you have understood the concepts, the question paper is going to be very easy for you. And if you don't learn, if you don't understand, if you take it very lightly, then of course nobody can help, right? So you have to learn the things very nicely. So children, today first we are going to start the revision work from our literature portion, right? So in literature, two chapters are there, right? That is going to come in your UT2. One is prose and the second one is poem. So poem is friends and the prose, that is the wedding gift that is there in your UT course. So let us revise the exercises that we have done in the poem as well as in the prose, right? So everybody is ready? Come on, let us revise it, okay? And here we start, okay? So the friends poem, this we have learned in the from our literature book. And first let us start with the poet, okay? The one who has written the poem, friends. So who is the poet of the poem, friends? आपको देखो क्वेश्चंस कैसे कैसे आ सकते हैं, यू हैव टू लिसन टू मी वेरी केयरफुली, ठीक है? लाइक नेम द पोएट ऑफ द पोएम फ्रेंड्स. सो द आंसर इज एबी फारवेल ब्राउन. हु इज द वन हु हैज रिटन दिस पोएम फ्रेंड्स? एबी फारवेल ब्राउन. सो लाइक देयर विल बी फोर ऑप्शंस गिवन. एज यू नो दैट द क्वेश्चन पेपर इज एमसीक्यू बेस्ड, सो फोर ऑप्शंस विल बी गिवन. देयर विल बी फॉर थ्री डिफरेंट नेम्स ऑफ द पोएट एंड देन देयर विल बी वन ऑप्शन विच इज द करेक्ट वन. सो आप उसको तभी आइडेंटिफाई कर पाएंगे इफ यू हैव लर्न इट, इफ यू नो द राइट आंसर, राइट? सो हु इज द पोएट ऑफ द पोएम फ्रेंड्स? एबी फारवेल ब्राउन, राइट? एंड वॉट इज दिस पोएम इज ऑल अबाउट? दिस फ्रेंड्स पोएम इज अबाउट द नेचर, राइट? द गिफ्ट ऑफ नेचर दैट वी ऑल आर ब्लेस्ड विथ, राइट? हम सबको ब्लेसिंग्स किससे मिली हुई है? मदर नेचर ने हमें बहुत सारी चीजें दी हैं. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर पोएम इज डेडिकेटेड टू द मदर नेचर हु ऑल्सो इज अ फ्रेंड ऑफ अस, राइट? हमारी बेस्ट फ्रेंड है क्योंकि ये हमारी देखभाल करता है, हमारे को एवरीथिंग इट इज प्रोवाइडिंग अस. इट प्रोवाइड्स अस शेल्टर, इट प्रोवाइड्स अस फूड, इट प्रोवाइड्स अस वाटर. एवरीथिंग द लाइफ दैट दैट वी आर लिविंग इज गिवन थ्रू द मदर नेचर. सो दैट्स वाई दे आर आर best friends in fact, right? So let us now read out this poem children and how the questions can come from this poem, that I also am going to tell you one by one, okay? So let us start reading out first. How good to lie a little while and look up through the tree. The sky is like a kind big smile bent sweetly over me. The sun flickers through the lace of leaves above my head and kisses me upon the face like mother before her bed. The wind comes sealing over the grass. What is this? Over. We is marked as apostrophe. So these are abbreviations, children, right? The wind comes stealing over the grass to whisper pretty things. And though I cannot see him pass, I feel his careful wings. So many gentle friends are near, whom one can scarcely see. A child should never feel a fear, wherever he may be. right? So it's a very nice poem which says about the mother nature. So here when the poet is roaming around and he is just lying on the grass, the poetess who is lying on the green grass, so what does she feel? And she is expressing her feelings, right? So what does she say? That when she is lying on the, how good to lie a little while and look up through the tree, right? So when she is lying down and just she is looking at the tree, so the sky, it looks like a kind big smile. So like a kind big and gentle smile, and that bends sweetly over me, right? When the sunshine flickers means coming through the hole. आपने माइक्रोस्कोप या कोई ऐसा आप सनग्लास लेते हैं, सो देयर फ्रॉम दैट यू कैन सी ना द पिन ऑफ रे दैट इज कमिंग, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज फ्लिकरिंग, राइट? सो द सनशाइन इज फ्लिकरिंग थ्रू द लेस ऑफ लीव्स. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लेस? द रोज ऑफ लीव्स, राइट? दैट इज ऑन द ट्री. एंड देन फ्रॉम दैट फ्लिकर, फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर point from where the sun rays are just entering it, it is straight away coming where? It is just pointing on, it is coming on the, on my face. And the sunshine feels like, jaisa aisa lag raha hai ki wo sunshine mere gaalon ko kiss kar raha hai, just like our mother kisses us before going for bed, right? हम सोने से पहले हमारी मॉम हमें गुड नाइट किस करती है. द सेम वे द सनशाइन ऑल्सो इज किसिंग अस, राइट? देन व्हाट द विंड इज ब्लोइंग. सो व्हाट डज द विंड रिजेंबल्स लाइक? द विंड कम्स स्टीलिंग ओवर द ग्रास, ग्रास के ऊपर से बहता हुआ जा रहा है. To whisper pretty things, as if like the wind when it blows throughout, so something it is whispering. I can't understand, but something it is whispering, right? And though I cannot see him pass, because wind cannot be seen through the naked eyes. Can you see wind? No, we can't see air. But then we can feel it, right? So though we cannot see it, but then I can feel the careful wings. So the wind is here resembling with the wings of the butterfly or of the bird. जैसे butterfly के wings जो होते हैं बहुत pretty से सुंदर से flap करते हैं और उसमें से एक हवा निकलती है, and it is so smooth when it touches. So the same way wind is also resembling the wings of the butterfly, right? Now next one is so many gentle friends are near. हमारे देखो हमारे आस पास. When I am there in the nature, right? When I am surrounded with the nature, trees, grass, birds, animals, sky, sunshine, everything. So they are all our gentle friends, right? They do they ever harm us? नहीं ना, they never ever harm us. So they, that's why they, the poet says that they are our gentle friends, and whom one can scarcely see, you can rarely see them, right? क्योंकि बिकॉज सी वी आर लिविंग इन अ सिटी लाइफ, हम सब शहर में रहते हैं और हम ये नेचर को बहुत कम फील कर पाते हैं. सनशाइन ले पाना, ट्रीज को देखना, स्काई खुले आसमान पर ऐसे देखना, तो दीज आर वेरी स्कार्स इन आवर लाइफ, राइट? एंड अ चाइल्ड शुड नेवर फील फियर वेन एवर ही मे बी. जब भी वो नेचर के पास है तो उसे कभी डरने की जरूरत ही नहीं है, बिकॉज नेचर इज ऑलवेज टेकिंग केयर ऑफ अस, राइट? सो द गिफ्ट ऑफ नेचर आर ट्रूली आर फ्रेंड्स, सो दे आर ऑलवेज देयर फॉर अस, राइट? Now children, let me tell you कि कैसे आपको questions इसमें आ सकते हैं. So you have to learn minimum 8 lines of the poem. ठीक है? These 4 and these 2 means 2 paragraphs you have to learn. How good to lie a little while and look up through the tree. The sun is like a kind big smile bent sweetly over me. The sunshine flickers through the lace of leaves above my head and kisses me upon the face. Like mother before bed. So if you learn like this, it will be very easy for you, right? So try to make a rhyme using like a song, the way you sing a song. So then if you sing it like that, it will be very easy for you to learn. So minimum you have to learn 8 lines of the poem, right? और आपको कहीं से भी यहाँ कहीं बीच से आपको थोड़ा सा कुछ पार्ट पोएम का मिसिंग रहेगा एंड यू हैव टू फिल दैट lines of the poem or the words of the poem. For an example, like agar aapko diya hai, how good to lie a dash. So what you have to write? Little while. And look up dash. So you have to write through the tree. The sky is like dash. So a kind big smile. Dash, dash over me. So you have to write bent sweetly over me. So this way the question may come in your UT2, right? And then the next is like here, these questions may also come, like for an example, what does the poet compare each one of these things to the nature to? Like sky. So what is the sky here is compared with? Like a, what we have seen, the sky is like a kind big smile. So here the sky is compared with the kind big smile, right? Then leaves किससे compare किया गया है? Tall leaves look like mothers, like leaves को compare किया गया है. Here you can see the kisses above the rose, lace of leaves से compare किया गया है, that the kisses that are given on the face by the mother, right? Now next one, let's see. Sunshine is compared as with the mother's kiss. Right? Wind को किससे compare किया गया है? Wind is compared with the careful wings, right? Of a butterfly, right? So this way you have to learn them, right? और इसके अलावा आपने word meanings भी इसमें दिए हुए हैं, so that also you have to learn, okay? Now let us now revise the next chapter, that is the prose, the wedding gift. So this prose is basically about the old time mein, ancient time mein, there was a habit of the kings and princes, they used to feel it as a pleasure to hunt animals, right? So you all are aware about the stories of famous stories of Akbar and Birbal. So this is also one of the story, very famous story of Akbar and Birbal. So Akbar, he was a great emperor, and Birbal was one of the courtier of Akbar. ठीक है, courtier किसे कहते हैं? जो ऐसे ministers, जैसे इस समय की अगर मैं बात करूँ आपका, तो आप देख सकते हैं प्रधानमंत्री, president ये होते हैं, और बहुत सारे home ministers, chief minister, then defence minister, ये सब रहते हैं ना? So the defence minister, home minister, ये सब क्या है? Courtiers हैं. राइट right? सो राजा होते थे, और राजा के जो अलग अलग मंत्री होते थे, अलग अलग जिनको काम दिया गया होता था, सो दे वर कॉल्ड एज कोर्टियर्स. राइट, सो कोर्टियर के वो एक मिनिस्टर थे बीरबल. राइट, सो इन ओल्डन टाइम्स किंग, एवरीबडी, दे किंग्स वर वेरी मच फॉन्ड ऑफ यू नो हंटिंग एनिमल्स, एंड एम्परर अकबर भी वो बहुत पसंद करते थे हंटिंग करना. सो ही यूज टू हंट from the childhood, but then Birbal ko ye cheez acha nahi lagta tha. He did not approve this needless killing of the animals, so he used to go with Akbar, Emperor Akbar, but then he like that Akbar is hunting the animals, the animals which have done no wrong to anyone, and they just get killed because of pleasure, right? For people, right? So then he just thought that I need to teach some lesson to King Emperor Akbar. So what did he think? One day what happened? Birbal, he was found missing. तो अकबर ने कहा कि ये कहाँ चला गया बीरबल, एंड देन ही सॉ दैट बीरबल वाज स्टैंडिंग अंडर अ ट्री एंड ही वाज लुकिंग एट द ब्रांचेस. राइट, सो बीरबल को अकबर ने बुलाया, बीरबल चलो आ जाओ, अदरवाइज द हॉर्स, द एनिमल्स आर गोइंग टू कम हियर. सो देन व्हाट डिड बीरबल से? बीरबल से दैट फॉरगिव मी सायर, द बर्ड्स आर हैविंग सच एन इंटरेस्टिंग डिस्कशन दैट आई कैन नॉट स्टॉप लिसनिंग टू देम. सो Akbar was amazed to hear that what, the birds are discussing something, are you able to understand that what they are discussing? So out of fun, then Emperor Akbar also asks, okay, so just tell me what they are discussing. Are they discussing politics or maybe law? So the courtiers present there, they also started laughing, listening to Emperor Akbar. So Birbal replied, "No, sir, the queen bird's son is getting married and she is talking about it with her friend." So her friend is there and she is talking about that. And she wants to gift a what? She wants to gift a jungle which is, you know, without the animals. So then Akbar said, "Oh, come on, where, what this queen bird is saying, where she can find the jungle?" This, so she, he said, Birbal said, "Ki wo yehi jungle jo jahan par hum shikar karne aaye hain, she wants to gift this jungle as a gift, as a wedding gift." So then Akbar said that, "Oh my god, she is so foolish. Right, this jungle, this forest is not vacant with animals. There are so many animals here, birds here. So where she can find an empty forest? This is not an empty forest." So then the friends, the Birbal said, "Ki bird ke friend ne bhi yehi usko kaha." So then the queen bird said or replied that the way king is, you know, hunting the animals, soon this forest will be free from all the animals. It will be completely free from all the animals. There won't be any animal left in this jungle. So then I can give this jungle as a gift for, as a wedding gift to my son and my daughter-in-law. So then Akbar actually understood that what Birbal wants to tell him. Birbal kya bolna cha raha tha, Akbar ko samajh mein aa gaya. Aur tab Akbar ne apne sare hunting party ko kya bola? "I don't want to hunt anymore. I don't feel like hunting anymore. Ab se main hunting karna nahi chahta." Right? So this way Birbal helped Akbar to get rid of such a bad habit that he had been following throughout his life, right? So, and this way he also helped the animals to, who were trapped and they were killed by the emperors, by the kings or by the princes, right? So, this is the story that we have learned in this. Now, what we are going to do, beta? Now, we are going to revise the notebook exercises from the lesson that we have learned. Okay, so humne lesson mein aapko Neelu ma'am ne sare notes aapko diye the na, word meaning, new words, exercises. So one by one we are going to revise that. Okay, so let me just open it first. Okay, I'm going to again share the screen, and then just a second. Let me go to unit test 2 first. We are going to revise friends. Okay, friends poem. So here in the notebook you have done this word meaning, right? Aapne word meaning kiya tha. So what is the meaning of flickers? Means it means shines unsteadily. So isme aapko kaisa diya rahega? Like word meaning, word will be given and there will be four options. So you have to choose the right option. Like flickers ka maan lo aapko diya hai, shines unsteadily, shines dull, shines brightly, or doesn't shine. So which is the correct option? Shines unsteadily, right? Lace of leaves, row of leaves. Come stealing, comes very quietly. Come stealing means comes very quietly. And scarcely means hardly or rarely, right? Now, next is question answer. Also, ma'am has given you, Neelu ma'am. What does the poet see when he lies down and look up? When the poet lies down, she looks up through the tree and sees the sky smiling sweetly over her, right? What does the sunshine do? The sunshine flickers through the lace of leaves above her head. अब आप कहोगे, मैम आप क्वेश्चन आंसर क्यों करा रही हैं? आपने तो कहा एमसीक्यू बेस्ड क्वेश्चन पेपर रहेगा. बेटा क्वेश्चन आंसर भी आ सकता है आपको. लाइक फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल क्वेश्चन विल बी गिवन, व्हाट डज द सनशाइन डू, एंड देयर विल बी फोर डिफरेंट आंसर्स. सो यू हैव टू चूज द करेक्ट आंसर. आप करेक्ट आंसर कैसे चूज कर पाएंगे? ओनली व्हेन यू नो द राइट आंसर. सो द राइट आंसर इज द सनशाइन फ्लिकर्स थ्रू द लेस ऑफ लीव्स अबव हर हेड. दिस इज विल बी द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. ओके, व्हाट डज द विंड डू? द विंड कम्स स्टीलिंग ओवर द ग्रास टू विस्पर प्रीटी थिंग्स टू द पोएट. What does the poet feel that a child need not fear? The poet feels that a child not to fear because they were gentle friends, right? And ye wala last question, why do you think the poet calls these gifts nature our friends? The poet calls these gifts of nature our friends because they help us in various ways and are always around to cheer us up, right? So this is what you have learned in this poem, friends. Now, अब हम प्रोज में देख लेते हैं. प्रोज में मैम ने आपको क्या क्या कराया था, right? The wedding gift. So first we will revise the book exercise, okay? So in the book exercise, ma'am has already given you this. A group of, can you remember? Here are some clues. Find words from the story from the following group of words. A group of people going to the forest to kill animal. They are called hunting party, right? People who are going to kill animals in the forest, they are called as hunting party. Animals they that are caught by hunters, they say trapped animals, right? An outdoor activity that is harmful to others, they say cruel sport, right? Activities connected to ruling a country, that is called as politics, hai na? Country ko rule karna, politics, that is called as politics. A present given to a bride and groom, usse kya kehte hain? Wedding gift, hai na? Wedding gift, shaadi ka gift, right? Now, next one. See here what you have learned. Here you have learned about the adjective, that is describing words, right? So what does the describing words or the adjective they tell? They tell us about the, they describe the noun, like a big hunting party. So which party? Hunting, big hunting party. Like cruel sport. So which kind of sport? Cruel sport. So sport is a noun and cruel, which is describing the sport, that is an adjective, right? So this is how you have to, you already you have done this book exercise, ma'am ne aise karaya tha, okay? Now let us talk about the apostrophes or possessive nouns. So when we are using these apostrophes, when we have to show the possession of something, like this is my pen, for an example I want to say something, this is my pen. So when Shalini's pen, so this particular pen belongs to Shalini, then in that case I can say Shalini's pen. So in that case, what we are going to do, we are going to use apostrophe. For an example, nurse's hostel. So hostel jahan nurse kaam karti hai, so nurse's hostel. Teacher ka room, the room that is for teacher, so teacher's room. Or clothes made for ladies, they are called ladies clothes, right? And remember children, when there at the end, already the last mein agar s add kiya hai, to nurses agar plural form mein hai word noun, so aapko kya karna hai, plural form mein agar noun hai, so aapko apostrophe s ke baad lagani hai, right? Generally what we do, generally hum karte jaise bird ka son, तो बर्ड में एपोस्ट्रोफी एक लगाएंगे एंड देन वी एड एस बर्ड्स सन. बट व्हेन द नाउन इज प्लूरल देन व्हाट वी डू, वी हैव टू जस्ट एड एपोस्ट्रोफी एट द एंड, राइट? लाइक सी द बुक ऑफ द टीचर, सो द टीचर्स बुक. द बैग्स ऑफ द गर्ल्स, सो हियर प्लूरल नाउन, सो द गर्ल्स, यहाँ ओनली वी हैव टू जस्ट एड एपोस्ट्रोफी, राइट? Already S is there at the end. Girl's bag, the baby's smile, the donkey's ears, the villager's huts, the soldier's uniforms, right? Now, next one. See, match the tools to the work they help us to do, right? Like, see, needle and thread, what do they help us to? Sewing, right? Pencil and paper, they help us in writing. Fork and spoon, they help us in eating. Brushes and colors, they help us in painting. Utensils and stove, they help us in cooking, right? Now, match the tools to the people with special jobs. Syringe, bandages and thermometer, they help the nurse, right? So, nurse uses these tools, that is syringe, bandage and thermometer, right? Scissors, comb and hair dryer. Who uses it? A barber uses it, right? Next. Wire, screwdriver and drill. Who uses it? Electrician uses it. plow, spade and sickle. Who uses this? Farmer uses it. Saw, hammer and nails are used by carpenter, right? Now, next one. See? Now, you have learned about the past tense. मैंने आपको tense पढ़ाया था. So, in that, you got to know that when a verb is, you know, when we are going to make a sentence in a past tense, right? हमें अगर किसी sentence को बताना है that action has happened in the past tense, then what do? We add D or ED at the root verb, right? Like play, I play. So, this is present tense. And when I want to say that मैंने खेला था, so I am going to use played. In the root word play, I will add ED, played, right? So, I played. That becomes past tense. So, here what we have to do? We have to add ED at the end, like clean. So, clean, ED, like. Now, here you can see already last letter is E. So, when there is E at the end, we don't have to add again ED. We have to just add D at the end. So, it becomes liked, right? It becomes the second form of the word. That is V2. Smile becomes smiled. Brush becomes brushed. Comb becomes combed. Stop becomes stopped. Now, here you can see, children, that there are there are some words you will find that where we double the last letter. Like, see this one, stop. So, in this word, what we do when we are making the root verb into the second form, stop mein hume ek last mein double kar dena hai. Double P and then we have to add ED. Stopped. Save, saved. Rub, again see here, there are some words, as I told you, they are exceptional words. We have to double the last letter, like RUBBED, rubbed. Slip, SLIPPED, slipped. So, there are some exceptional words where we have to double the letter, the last letter before adding ED, okay? So, that you will learn by time. Don't worry about it, okay? Now, so these are the book exercises that we have done in this chapter, the wedding gift, okay? Now, let us see the notebook exercises that Neelu ma'am has given you, right? So, these are the new words, okay? New words, there are total 16 new words ma'am has given you. And you are supposed to learn all of them, okay? Aapko kaise aa sakta hai? Like for an example, the word like pleasure if it's given. So, some letters are missing in that. Like for an example, it is given like P is written P dash E dash S dash dash dash. Or last letter is given E. So then you have to understand that what word you can make. So if you have already learned this word, you will know it, right? So P L E A S U R E. This is how you are supposed to fill it. Pleasure, trapped, approve, wondered, interesting, discussion, politics, courtiers, pretended, wedding. Puzzled, exactly, curiously, continued, silent or chirping. These all words you need to by heart it. Okay, spellings should be learned properly. Now, next, see word meanings. Approve. What is the meaning of approve? So, there will be four options given and you have to tell the right option. So, approve means agree or like. Needless means not necessary. Zarurat nahi hai jo. Break the habit means stop doing something. Right? Wondered means wanted to know something. Give up means to surrender. Courtiers means minister. Pretended means behaved as if something was real. Majesty means a term used for king. Right? Term used kiya tha, your majesty. That is used for a king. Right? Now, this was a book exercise that you have done in the notebook, right? Birbal did not support the dash. So, what is the answer? Unnecessary killing of animals. Akbar had hunted since childhood. So, difficult for, that's why it was difficult for him to break the habit, right? When Akbar looked around, he found Birbal standing under a tree staring up at the branches. Birbal said that he was listening to the birds who were talking about the queen bird's son wedding, right? And these question answers, beta, you have to learn them, okay? Question answer aapko aa sakta hai, like what did Akbar like to do? So you have to tell the answer, like Akbar like to hunt animals, Akbar like to talk politics, or Akbar like to gossip, or Akbar like to go for a war. So what is the right answer? Hunt animals, right? So these all question answers, I'm not going to repeat it again. These question answers you have to learn them nicely, okay? Understood everyone, children, right? So these book exercises and notebook exercises already we have revised it. Now children, what I'm going to do next is, children, so today I'm going to give you a worksheet, okay? I will be giving you a worksheet as a homework. Ye aapko main worksheet de rahi hu, ye aapka homework hai. This you have to solve it on your own in your English notebook, theek hai? Apni notebook mein ise solve karenge, answers likhenge, but not looking at the answers. If you don't know the answer, learn it, then write down the answer, okay? And if you are done, then you can send the pic of that worksheet. When you have completed the writing the answers, you can send it between 12 to 12:30 during the WhatsApp group when it is open. So you can send that, okay? The next day I will send the answer key of it. Next day main answer key bhejungi, tab aap apne answers check kar sakte hain, theek hai? So let me just show you that worksheet, okay? Just give me a second and here I'll just show you, okay? So this is the worksheet that you are supposed to do it, okay? Yeah, this one, okay? So this is the worksheet from the literature. This is worksheet one, literature portion only I have taken. So like complete the lines of the poem. How good to dash. So how good to, you know the poem, right? And look up the sky shining up. The sunshine flickers through the lace of leaves of the, you already know, right? In the poem, friends, what does the poet compare each one of these with? Sky ko kisse compare kiya tha? Big kind smile. Sunshine like mother's kiss. Wind was compared with careful wings, right? Name the poet of the poem, friends. Okay, I think I need to just zoom it, okay? Yeah, now I think it's visible. Name the poet of the poem, friends. So Abby Farwell, right, is the poet of the poem Friends. Now complete the following spellings. So this is puzzled, pleasure, chirping, trapped, discussion, courtiers. You have to write these spellings, okay? Word meaning, you have to tell the meanings of the word. Approve, needless, majesty, scarcely, flickers, give up, right? Fill in the blanks. In olden days, all kings hunted for. अब देखो आप कहोगे मैम फिल इन दी ब्लैंक्स तो आपका नोटबुक में नहीं था. बेटा यू हैव टू लर्न दी एक्सरसाइजेस वेरी वेल, राइट? सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम लर्निंग दी एक्सरसाइज, व्हाट एल्स यू हैव टू डू? सी आई शोड यू, राइट? आपको मैंने ये दिखाया था ना, ये सारे बुक का आपको ये अच्छे से पढ़ना है. यू नीड टू लर्न इट नाइसली. यू हैव टू रीड द एंटायर स्टोरी. सो आपको स्टोरी में से कहीं से भी आपको ब्लैंक्स, फिल इन दी ब्लैंक्स आ सकता है, या फिर हु सेड टू हुम आ सकता है. लाइक फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल आपको दिया है, इन ओल्डन डेज ऑल किंग्स एंड प्रिंसेस हंटेड डैश फॉर प्लेजर. So animals for pleasure. Or Birbal did not dash off this dash killing of animals. So kya hoga? Approve of this needless killing of animals, right? So this way the questions can be asked, okay? It can be twisted. Only you can answer, only you can understand if you have read the chapter thoroughly, okay? So here let us do it once again. Let's see. So in olden days all kings hunted for pleasure, right? Birbal did not dash off this needless killing of animals. Birbal did not approve. Dash liked to hunt animals. Who liked to hunt animals? Akbar. The emperor waited on and Dash to kill the trapped animal. Kisko wait kiya tha? Animal ko, kaun se animal ko trap karke kill karna chaha tha? Elephant ko, right. And now, who said to whom? Kisne ye kaha tha? Forgive me, sire. Okay, here the spelling of sire is wrong. Here it should not be H. The spelling of sire. Here, beta, you can make a correction. Here, there won't be H into it. Okay, sire, the spelling of sire is S-I-R-E. No, don't add H. Okay, sire. Forgive me, sire, who said this? Birbal. Are they discussing politics? Ye politics discuss kar rahe hain. Who said this? Akbar said to Birbal. Have they invited you to the wedding? Who said this? Akbar said to Birbal. I no longer feel like hunting. Who said this? Akbar said to the hunting party, right? Now, what do these tools help us to do? Ye tools hame kya help karte hai? Needle and thread, sieving. Fork and spoon, eating. Brushes and colors, painting, right? Now, answer the following questions. These question answers you have to do, right? And add ed or d to make them into past form. Like, liked. Comb, combed. Rub, here the last letter will get double. Rubbed, save, saved, right? So, I have given you total 10 questions. You have to do it on your own, okay? And you have to solve this nicely. And then tomorrow I will share the answer key of this worksheet. So, you can check your answers. So, for now, this much is sufficient. We will meet again in our next class. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye, everyone.